Hi students, today we will discuss solution of differential equation for forced oscillation. In previous class, we obtained differential equation for forced oscillation. The differential equation for forced oscillation is given as m into d2x by dt square plus r into dx by dt plus kx is equal to f0 sin qt. This is the differential equation for forced oscillation. Solution of this equation consisting of two parts. First part is complementary function and another part is particular integral. Complementary function. If this differential equation is considering homogeneous differential equation, then m into d2x by dt square plus r dx by dt plus kx is equal to consider 0, considering only homogeneous part of differential equation, then its solution is x is equal to a e raised to minus rt upon 2m sine of omega dash t minus phi. Equation number 2. This solution represent transient state of the oscillator. It means that the oscillator neither oscillate with natural frequency nor with external periodic force frequency. These oscillations die away with time as e raised to minus rt upon 2m. This complementary function and this type of solution we see in case of damped oscillation. Now, solution particular integral. Particular integral is the part of solution that represent steady state of the oscillator. In complementary function, we saw solution is neither oscillatory with natural frequency and nor oscillatory with external periodic force frequency. In particular integral, we get steady state solution of the oscillator. Consider solution x is equal to a sine qt minus phi. This is steady state solution or particular integral. In this solution, a and phi are arbitrary constant. Take derivative with respect to t, then we get dx by dt is equal to a q. The derivative of sine is cos qt minus phi. Again differentiate with respect to t, then we get d2x by dt square is equal to minus a q square sine of qt minus phi. Now this first derivative, second derivative and value of x put in a differential equation m into d2x by dt square plus r into dx by dt plus kx is equal to f0 sin qt. Put the value of x, dx by dt and d2x by dt square. Then we get minus m a q square sin of qt minus phi plus r times a q cos of qt minus phi plus k a sin qt minus phi is equal to f0 sin qt. Now in this term and in this term, take sin qt minus phi as a common, then a inside the bracket k minus mq square sine of qt minus phi plus raq cos of qt minus phi is equal to f0 sin qt. F0 sin qt is rearrange the term, that is f0 sin qt, here subtract phi and add phi from qt. Then we have f0 sin of qt minus phi plus phi. This qt minus phi consider as alpha and phi, this second phi, as a beta, and take the expansion of this sin qt minus phi plus phi, that is expansion as like sin alpha plus beta. Then we get the expansion of sin alpha plus beta is sin alpha cos beta plus cos alpha sin beta. Therefore we have f0 sin of qt minus phi f0 inside the bracket sin of qt minus phi cos phi plus cos qt minus phi sin phi. Along this side, a k minus mq square sin of qt minus phi plus raq cos of qt minus phi. After expansion of sin, we get such type of equation. In this equation, compare the coefficient of sin qt minus phi and cos qt minus phi. Then we get a k minus mq square is equal to f0 cos phi. Here, coefficient of sin qt minus phi is f0 cos phi. Equation number 4. Similarly, comparing the coefficient of cos qt minus phi, we get raq is equal to f0 sin phi, equation number 5. Now, squaring and adding equation 4 and 5, we get a square k minus mq square bracket square plus r square a square q square is equal to f0 square sin square phi plus f0 square cos square phi. We know that sin square phi plus cos square phi is equal to 1. Then a square as a common, we get a square inside the bracket k minus mq square bracket square plus r square q square is equal to f0 square. Finally, a square is equal to f0 square divided by k minus mq square bracket square plus r square q square. Taking square root, then we get a is equal to f0 divided by square root of k minus mq square bracket square plus r square q square. This is the formula for amplitude of forced oscillation. Divide equation 4 and 5, we get f0 sin phi divided by f0 cos phi, that is equal to raq divided by a into k minus mq square. F0 get cancelled. Then we get sin phi upon cos phi, that is tan phi is equal to rq divided by k minus mq square. Here a also get cancelled. Then tan phi is equal to rq divided by k minus mq square. It gives that phi is equal to tan inverse rq divided by k minus mq square. Solution, that is particular integral, is taken x is equal to a sin qt minus phi. Put the value of a, then we get x is equal to the value of a is f0 divided by square root of k minus mq square plus r square q square. X is equal to f0 square root of k minus mq square bracket square plus r square q square sine of qt minus phi. This is the complete solution of differential equation of forced oscillator. Thank you.